Hi there, meet April. April is under a lot of pressure. She is stressed out. She has to deploy a new finance application in the next couple of weeks. She's pretty worried because this type of thing usually takes months and can be very complicated, very inefficient. Well, now I want you to meet Julian. He's the one who will make this problem go away with a Microsoft private cloud solution that provides more agility and customization on terms that work for April. Coming up right now, we'll look at how IT can respond to critical, time-sensitive business needs like you've never seen before. Microsoft has 25 technology centers worldwide to help you, our customers, and our partners see firsthand how Microsoft's platform and partner solutions can help get business done. With me is Mike Jenny, an MTC technology architect. Hi there, Mike.
Hello, Christine.
Thanks for being here. We're looking forward to speaking with you.
Thanks.
All right, great. Well, he's going to connect the dots for us, essentially help us understand how Microsoft private cloud solutions can help us face and solve challenges pretty easily and efficiently. And for this event, we have experts on hand, live, to answer your questions in real time. So fire off any questions as they come up for you. In addition to our experts, we have a wealth of resources for you to investigate. These are brought to you by our global partners. So, Mike, what we're going to be seeing are real IT scenarios, things that happen every single day, right?
Right. The scenarios that we see happen every day, but really what doesn't happen every day yet is the solution that we're going to see. And that solution brought to us by the Microsoft private cloud offering. Mm-hmm. So what we're going to end up seeing is a subset of the System Center suite of products and how those products integrate together and allow individuals like April and Julian to both accomplish their individual goals.
Right. So essentially how everything works in a very comprehensive way. And that's pretty key as we're going to go through today. All right. So let's go back to April to get it started. Now remember, she's stressed out. She's the finance IT lead. She has to get the new finance tracker deployed and fast. This is a tall order. So let's check in with April.
Today, my application is sitting in a pre-production environment, and we're really excited to get this application off the ground. Now, the team's been testing to make sure that it's running well, and with testing almost complete, we want to get our deployment scheduled. You know, the last time we had an application deployment, it was a long process filled with emails and back and forth with IT, and I'm getting really nervous. Now, I've submitted my service request earlier, and I'm going to go ahead and contact Julian, our IT person on hand, just to make sure that he has everything he needs so I can have my production environment for our new application.
Hello, April.
Hey, Julian, how are you?
Great. How's New York?
It's going great, but I got to tell you, we're under a lot of pressure out here to get our new application finance tracker off the ground. And I submitted a service request, and I know that you're the person on point to ensure that we get our final production environment created. So, how's it going?
Yeah, I saw your request. How much time do you need? When do you plan to deploy this application?
Well, we'd like to get this application off the ground in the next few weeks, and I want to make sure that we don't go over schedule. So, is that something you can help me with?
Oh, I think I can do it much faster than that.
Wow. All right. Well, do you have all the components that you need? Do you have any questions?
I'm pretty sure I have all the information that I need, but are you going to be online later on just in case I have some questions for you?
Yeah, I'll be online today. So just let me know if you need anything.
No problem.
All right. Talk to you later.
Bye.
Bye.
I see her request in the System Center screen, but I also see a higher priority ticket. Let me just take a look at what this is. Oh, this is actually very much related. The private cloud environment that I'm going to use to deploy for April is actually hosted in one of our data centers, and we're monitoring all of our data centers with System Center. All the physical equipment, the virtual applications, and the physical applications installed. What it's telling me is that one of my clusters that I was planning to use is running out of capacity. And this is very important for me to know because I don't want to impact other environments when I provision an environment for April. What's more important is that System Center allows me to automatically create this type of change request and maintain my ITIL compliance processes. We used to have a very manual process for extending the physical infrastructure, but we're actually going to implement an automated process as well. And I happened to convert one of our manual processes into the automated process using System Center. And I'm going to test this scenario right now. All I have to do is specify one of the systems that I know is already racked in my data center. And because I'm testing it, I am kicking it off manually. But of course, I can convert it later once we're comfortable with the process to be triggered automatically on the creation of the change request. I can see everything that's happening, and while it's provisioning a new node, it will actually record everything in the change tracking log, again, helping my ITIL process compliance status. I can also continuously improve this process by monitoring any steps in the process that take longer than I expect. And that way I can improve the response time to my business.
So Mike, this is happening really quickly. What did we just see?
So what we just saw, two very common scenarios. First, I have someone from the business, in this case April, who's in the finance department. She's making a request of IT for service. In this case, she needs to get her application deployed, sounds like sooner rather than later. Mm-hmm. The second thing that we saw is Julian, that data center manager, he's dealing with this issue of capacity, right? He saw that his environment was starting to reach a threshold that he had previously set, so he's going to start the process of actually provisioning additional capacity into his data center for both April's application, but also for the good of all the private clouds that are deployed within his environment.
And Microsoft tackles this problem in a very different way. Could you explain?
Sure. I'll explain it by breaking it down into four areas. And the first and foremost, we like to say that when it comes to private clouds, it's all about the application. And we'll see later on as we see how this application is deployed, how Microsoft's private cloud solution kind of comes together and provides an easy way to deploy the application. Because at the end of the day, that's the real business need here, is getting that application deployed.
And now, what I also understand is that this works across all platforms, and I know you guys have a special reason for doing that.
Right, so we like to say cross-platform from the metal up, and what we mean by that is not just being able to manage other hypervisors like VMware and Citrix, but also deep integration into our partner ecosphere with technologies like storage and networking, because when we talk about private clouds, some of the key components that I need are things like automation as well as elasticity. And in order to accomplish those two things, I need to have tight integration with that, really the entire ecosystem within my data center.
What I'm also noticing is Julian is really starting to lay the groundwork to handle this whole problem for April on April's terms. Can you get into that a little bit?
Sure. So what that is going to entail is the provisioning of, you know, a sliver of the data center for April and her department. That sliver, will term that a private cloud. And then Julian will empower April to have control over that private cloud environment to be able to do things like deploy her application on her terms.
And this doesn't matter. It doesn't matter where she is or where he is. This is all working in synchronicity no matter where they are. Is that correct?
Right. The idea of having to be, you know, close proximity to a data center, those days are really gone. In this case, my data center could be on one side of the country or the globe and my users on the other, or my business unit on the other. It's really not important.
It doesn't really matter anymore, right? So if you're just joining us, here's what we've been watching. We have April, who's a finance IT lead, and she has to deploy a new application within a matter of weeks. This is extremely stressful for her. Julian is the data center IT guy. He's the lead there taking care of this whole problem. And I think what we're going to see next year, Mike, is that he's starting to assemble the ingredients to make this all happen. This is the next step, correct?
Right. The first step in the process is actually creating a private cloud. And what we're going to see is those key ingredients that Julian has to assemble and configure, so to speak. And then we'll see how he delegates that private cloud to the finance department, or more specifically, April.
Okay. So let's get behind a little bit more of the magic right now and check in once again with Julian to see what's happening.
I have a lot of different hardware providers in my data center, and I need my private cloud management environment to support all of them. In this case, I have various storage types in storage providers, and I have actually classified them based on the performance characteristics for each storage. I'm actually going to use gold level storage for the production environment that April wants. That's based on our previous discussions with her. But also in our production environment, we recommend having at least two web front-end servers for load balancing. And I need to manage my load balancer so that it automatically configures it when April deploys the application. So System Center allows me to bring all these different hardware components that exist in my data center into one single pane. In fact, I can even manage multiple virtualization providers that I still have in my data center, such as VMware and Citrix.
It's pretty incredible what we're watching, Mike. Did he say something about gold?
Sure. So common analogy within data centers to have different levels of storage from a price perspective. So imagine having a platinum being my most expensive, most performant, gold maybe being kind of middle of the road, and then bronze being my least expensive, least performant storage. It sounds like in this case, through their testing, they've determined that that gold tier, that kind of middle of the road tier, is going to service the needs of April's app and provide the storage capabilities that she needs.
So it sounds like it's exactly what she needs, and this is part of the unified, comprehensive way that Microsoft approaches these problems. Is that correct?
Right. It's a good example where we're integrating with our storage partners to help automate some of the commonly performed tasks that need to occur in order to kind of bring this private cloud idea to a reality.
So idea going to reality, a lot of components are coming together, and I think let's go through the steps with Julian right now.
Now that I have all the components defined, let's see how I can create a private cloud environment for production application. System Center allows me to combine all these components through a simple method. I'm going to allow it to run on any of my devices. But because this application is externally accessible, I'm going to automatically attach this application to external network. And based on what I discussed about our requirements for multiple servers on the front end, I'm going to let the system automatically configure load balancer to do that. And I have predefined load balancing rules for that. Like I mentioned, I'm going to allow this application to run on the gold level storage. And if I want, I can limit how much the resources this application takes, but I'm actually going to take our default approach. And of course, as I said, it can run on multiple different hypervisor technologies. In this case, we standardize on Hyper-V. Everything I do is recorded and audited, so I can always report and go back and see exactly what has changed. So this was my personal best at creating private cloud. I think I have time to call Guinness World Records. The only other thing that I have to do is allow finance department to be able to use this private cloud. I already have a finance role predefined, and finance admins from my Active Directory is in there, and all I have to do is allow finance production environment to be managed by this group, and I'm done.
Mike, Julian is so calm, cool, and collected. What does April have now that she didn't have before that he just did so easily?
So technically what she has is she has her own little private cloud in their environment. So think of it as her own little sliver of the data center. She's got compute resources. Sounds like Julian included some network load balancing, so some network technology, some storage. So she has the capability to deploy her application. But remember, it's all about the app. We haven't gotten to the application yet, so that's what's coming up next.
That's what we're going to see next. I think it is time to see it in action, but I just want to make sure I understand. This is really all created just for April. That's that unified solution, comprehensive, customized.
Right.
Very special to Microsoft. You want to see it in action? Let's go back to Julian. Okay.
I was working with April's team when they were developing application. And I was able to understand exactly what requirements they need. And using System Center, I am able to define this in a simple to see model. I'm going to check on the template to make sure that it's compliant with our standards. Now, I know that in production environment, we actually need more than one server. So I'm going to increase this in my template and start with two servers. Now, when I start with two servers, I of course need to add my load balancer in that. And that's how simple it is for me to do. Before I actually save this template, I would like to check with April to make sure that she's okay with my changes. So I'm gonna call her.
Hey, Julian, how's it going over there?
Great, I'm almost done. I just have one more question.
Sure, go ahead.
When I worked with your developers during the dev cycle, we agreed on the infrastructure needs that you'll have. But in production environment, we actually recommend to have two web servers in order to load balance them. Are you okay with that?
Julian, you need to do whatever you can do to make sure that we can deploy this on time. So two web servers it is. Let's do it.
Okay, no problem. I will actually configure it to start with two, but grow automatically up to five.
Sounds amazing.
Okay, I will be done in a few minutes.
Wow. All right, I'll give you a call a little bit later just to check in with you.
Thanks, April.
All right, bye.
So Julian seemed to think that template was critical. He thought enough of it to call her and just make sure that it was okay. Why is the template so important, and why is Microsoft different?
So we are very different in that case. What the service template allows us to do is really model the application. In this case, it's the finance tracker application that April is so concerned about. Mm-hmm. And by having a model for the application, it allows us to deploy it in a very repeatable sense. So any business unit owner out there that has ever took an application through its life cycle from test, dev, and then into production has dealt with this challenge of, I deploy it once, it works, I deploy it again, something's not quite mm-hmm. the same. So this service template allows repeatability, and also, as we saw with Julian, it provides the way to configure how we want this service to grow. Going back to that elasticity, how do I want it to grow over time? And in this case, the number of web front-end servers initially will be configured with two, but as I meet performance thresholds, I can automatically grow that tier up to five.
So reliability and then also scalability. Did you hear him say just a couple of minutes?
Yes.
Okay.
We'll
I think we should check in because that's talking some game. Let's check in with Julian.
Okay, so I created a private cloud environment and I modified the application in order to comply with our standards for production environments. But I also have to make sure that our automated process for extending the host environment has finished before I allow April to deploy the application. So let me just double check on my production cluster. And yes, I actually see a third node that has joined my cluster. And that way my physical environment is ready for the virtual deployment of the application.
Julian said he was going to have this done in a couple of minutes. I don't believe him. I'm going to go ahead and give him a call to see if he's really going to make this happen today. Julian!
What's going on?
Julian, I'm freaking out over here. How's it going over there?
Oh, it's going to take another 2 months.
Julian, no, we can't do that.
Kidding. I'm all done, so if you share your desktop, I can actually show you how you can do it.
Julian, you said you're all done.
I am all done.
I got to see this. Let me share my desktop real quick.
So go in the web browser.
Yeah.
And you can see that now you have access to the finance production. So click on finance production cloud.
Got it.
And click on deploy.
Got it.
VMM service.
Yeah.
And choose a template.
All right.
Make sure you choose the production version 0.9.
Got it.
Wait. Are you ready?
Julian, I don't know. I mean, if we can get this done ahead of schedule, like, I've got butterflies in my stomach here.
Are you sure you're ready?
I think I'm ready. Can we just see if it works?
Okay. Click OK.
Wow.
And this is your app.
Wow. I'm excited. Like, I just can't believe that we can get this done on time. In fact, we're doing it ahead of schedule. Julian, this is amazing.
Whenever you're ready, you can hit the start deployment button and you'll be all set to go.
Julian, you're amazing. Next time you're in New York, beers are on me.
Great. I like wine, but beer's okay too.
Whatever you need.
Great.
Bye. Woo!
So, Mike, we need to find out where this celebration is happening, because clearly there is a celebration that is happening.
Indeed.
This was great. Over the past couple of minutes, we've really seen Microsoft's private cloud in action. Can we go over again exactly what happened, the components to it?
Sure. At a high level, what we saw, you know, four key areas. First and foremost, all about the application. So the business need that April had getting that application deployed, we've seen how Microsoft's private cloud solution will empower April to deploy that app on her terms, which is another one of those key tenets. The other two things that we saw involve, cross-platform from the middle up. We saw Julian you know, being able to manage and monitor, you know, other hypervisors, VMware and Citrix, but also that tight integration between the Microsoft solution and the broader data center ecosystem, including our networking partners and storage partners.
So everything's comprehensive.
Right.
Okay. So also, this is best in class, right?
Right. So the application in question that we're deploying, that this finance tracker application, you know, this is a workload that we Microsoft feel is best virtualized on the Microsoft platform.
Sounds good. Mike, you've been such a huge help today. Did you have a good time?
I did.
This
was
a lot of fun. I also think that we should give some applause to our Academy Award winning performers, Julian, aka Alex. Great job. And also April, aka Deanna. And thank you to our MTC partners. Thank you to our audience for participating today. If you'd like to know more about Microsoft's private cloud solution, be sure to complete your evaluation form where you can request a strategy briefing for the private cloud at an MTC near you. Stay tuned. Your chance to win an Xbox 360 Kinect is up next. Don't go anywhere. But first, we'll take a look at how one corporation is betting their investment in private cloud can help them double their business without growing their environmental footprint.
Unilever is a multinational corporation with 167,000 employees in over 100 countries. We view IT as a crucial enabler of the business, supporting our future plans for the growth of the business. Unilever has set a goal of doubling the size of the business without increasing its environmental footprint. We have found that virtualization is not enough to meet these goals. As a result, we're moving beyond virtualization to a private cloud infrastructure, while still getting the full benefits of our current investments. The private cloud model will give us increased agility moving forward, enabling us to respond more quickly to the needs of the business. Across the industry, IT is increasingly expected to provide capacity very rapidly, while at the same time continuing to maintain high levels of service. The system center management tools offer Unilever an integrated platform to monitor both infrastructure and applications. Using System Center 2012, we expect to be able to automate many repetitive tasks, which will allow us to focus on service improvements. Working with Avanade and Microsoft, Unilever has deployed more than 2,000 VMs on Windows Server Hyper-V. And today, we continue to partner with Avanade and Microsoft in driving increased efficiency in the management of the infrastructure, increasing our ability to support Unilever's growth.
Today we discussed one of the biggest transformations affecting IT today, cloud computing. We looked at the ways cloud computing is changing the way we think about IT and the way we do IT. Beyond helping companies become more agile and innovative, cloud computing is economical, driving efficiencies in both costs and utilization. We hope the information shared today address your questions and reveal the opportunities with cloud computing. We've put together several resources for you, including the private cloud assessment, software evaluation, and white paper. These are available here on this event site and at Microsoft.com/private cloud. Please take a moment to let us know what you think about this virtual event. The link to the evaluation directly below the video player. Complete the evaluation now for a chance to win an Xbox 360 Kinect. And don't forget, this entire event will be available on demand right here within the next 30 minutes. Thank you again for attending today. Until next time, Christine Chen logging off.